Okay, folks, I had did just do that, or I did just do that tutorial, but I just had a power cut, so I lost about 5 minutes or so of recording, and then anyway, just going over this again. So I did have a mouse, but I'm just gonna hit no. So now we want to add or start mashing some other textures into this. Ideally, I have a mouse texture that I'm gonna bring in. So I have this texture. Gonna go to my marquee tool, change it to fixed size. Set this to 1024 by 1024. And I'm just going to select a sample of this. I think this should be fine. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hit image and crop, and then image and copy. Or I could have just copied this sample, edit and copy. Then in my layer here, I'm going to hold down Control Shift and hit V to paste in place, or I can also go paste special and paste in place. Oh, and it didn't paste it in place. It's wonderful. Okay, so with this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put on another mask, meaning that I want to delete parts of this, but while using a mask so that I don't actually properly delete it, non-destructive. Now this mask is currently white, so that means the entire image is showing, this mouse texture is showing. So I'm going to fill this in black by going to edit and fill and choosing black. Nope, doesn't want to do it. Okay. I'll just take my paintbrush and paint the entire thing black because it's being absolutely special today. So now that my mask is now black, meaning that the whole thing's invisible, I'm gonna switch over to a white color. Gonna choose a brush to paint some moss on. I'm gonna use this brush like so. I'm going to turn down my opacity a bit, and I'm going to start painting white values onto my mask, meaning that my moss comes back. Now the areas that you definitely want to cover perhaps are the seams, okay? Obviously you don't want to make it too crazy, or else you'll notice that it's tiling again. But we literally just want to, yeah, that's too much. I'll choose a very low opacity and start painting in some moss into my tiles. It wouldn't hurt actually to get out some reference images and just making sure that you're doing something that actually in the real world looks proper. So maybe the moss is coming out through the little segments. If you don't like something, change your color back to black, and you can change the mask. When you're working with masks, make sure you are actually painting onto the mask itself. That way it'll work fine. So I'm just going to do this quickly because I've done it about three times already, but I kept losing work due to power cuts. I'm hoping it doesn't happen again. Maybe paint a bit of moss onto the stones itself. I would also sample other textures as well, not just two textures, but maybe, multiple textures, and you're trying to get an effect that looks good. Okay, and it's something like you would need to spend quite a bit of time doing. Texturing is quite a time consuming process. Okay, so from a distance, you can see that we are starting to get some mossy colors in there. But again, I wouldn't go OTT with it because whenever you're tiling this, it could look a bit crazy if all of it's covered in moss. This is what I would call tertiary detail, or maybe secondary detail. So yeah, maybe it's secondary detail, and then your tertiary detail might be putting in additional like cracks and stuff just to breaking up your texture a bit. But I think what I'm doing at the moment is all right. In my opinion, my artwork is never ever good enough. Artwork could always be just a little bit better. It's the lifestyle you choose. Okay, so just putting little bits of tertiary detail in there, bits of moss in here. There's probably too much, so I'm going to switch back to my other color, my black color, and on paint some stuff. Essentially just erasing it out. You know, I think there's maybe too much here. And it is just little subtle details that'll really give this away. Really make it stand out. Little bits of moss here and there, you know. Change to my white color, paint a bit more in. And always change, you know, from zoomed in to zoomed out. If you've got two screens, then bring up your navigator panel. And move that onto a second screen, really big. That means you can see up close on one screen and far away on another screen. Okay, so I don't want to spend too much longer with this because I've been restarting this quite a bit. But then again, art, it's just like you gotta keep going, keep doing bits more. Be very careful when it comes to your borders, because you've already set it up for tiling, so you don't want to destroy what you've already done. So I would heavily advise not going near the borders. Just going to delete bits of this. Remember, when I'm doing this, I'm not using, under any circumstances, my eraser tool. I'm painting in black or white. This is how the mask layers work. So maybe if you want to, you could go on to CG textures and find some other textures to work with. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to go back onto this layer here. I think some of the colors are just annoying me a bit. I think here these are too dark in comparison to these, so I might take out my dodge tool, which is here. Click and hold to make sure it's on dodge. And I think that just change it from to shadows. It might be on the wrong layer. Maybe not. Change its exposure. Nope. It's on the original layer. So yeah, what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to brighten some of these stones up. It's because we're using different parts of the texture, it looks a bit strange. I'm just touching some of this up a bit. And what I'm doing at the moment is being destructive, you know, because you can't really go back. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to save this as a PNG. Control, Shift, and S. Change that to PNG. Not a Pixar file, PNG file. T for textures, underscore stones, because that's the title. Underscore D for diffuse. Click Save. No compression, no interlacing. So, what we've done is we have taken our base tiles and we've added some moss detail in there. By using masks as well. So in the next video, I'm going to show you how to actually implement this into Unity.